Hi, today we're going to concentrate Treasure Ariel's curious kitten. Treasure hardly slept all night. Eric's ship was leaving early in the morning, and she was out of ideas. She couldn't think of any way to convince Eric to take them along. Treasure watched the sunrise from the window ledge. Her eyes were drawn to the dock. She wanted to be on that ship. Behind her, Treasure heard the door close softly. Then she saw Ariel tiptoe past her perch. Where was the princess going? Treasure knew one way to find out. Follow her. Ariel sneaked down the castle hallway. She opened the wooden door and slipped inside. Two trunks sat in the middle of the room with their lids open. They were filled with clothes and maps and books curtained to the side of each. Trunk was a large E. Ariel hurried over to the larger trunk. She lifted out a heavy wool cloak and tree-lined shirts. She swung her leg over the side of the trunk, and then Ariel climbed inside. She pulled the clothing she had taken out on top of her. Treasure arched her back. Oh, Ariel was so smart. She was stowing away in Eric's trunk. Eric's sailors would load the trunks onto the ship. Now they'd be loading Ariel too. Treasure wasn't about to be left behind. Besides, she knew a thing or two about stowing away. She leaped the lid of the smaller trunk, balancing on the edge for a moment. Then she jumped inside. Treasure dug under the piles of clothes. She found a nice soft spot next to Eric's pillow. She wiggled under a pair of boots and curled up to it. Before long, Treasure heard the sound of boots clomping on the castle floor. Someone shut the lid of the trunk. She felt the trunk being lifted. It tilted downward when it was carried down the stairs. She heard waves crashing on the shore. They must have been crossing the beach. The trunk tilted upward as he climbed the gangplank. Then the trunk was set down. The footsteps faded away. Treasure waited. She heard pipe whistles. She heard sailors calling. The ship swayed back and forth. The scent of the salt air got stronger. They were out to sea. Treasure shook out the breeches. She dug herself out the layers of clothes. With both paws, she pushed open the trunk's lid. She looked out, right at Ariel's shocked face. "Oh," Ariel said, bursting into laughter. "I guess we had the same idea." She lifted Treasure out of the trunk. I'll tell you a secret. Treasure, I couldn't stand to stay at the castle, she said, and Grimpsy couldn't stand to get on the ship, so we switched. He stayed behind to watch over things. I said goodbye to Eric and then snuck in here. You know, Eric wouldn't notice until later. He's always so busy. When we set sail, Treasure mouthed. That made sense. Send Grimpsy turned green on sea voyages before. He liked land much better. Ariel bit her lip. Now I just have to tell Eric, she said.